how you deploy a CycleCloud cluster. First, we'll show you how to get the necessary information required to enable CycleCloud to deploy a cluster in your subscription. Next, we'll talk about how you deploy and configure your CycleCloud server. We'll also show you how to deploy the cluster head node, which is where the scheduler runs for the workload managers. We're then going to show you how to deploy the compute nodes for your cluster. And once all those pieces are done, you'll now have a working cluster. And so we'll show you how to run NVIDIA SMI, the NCL tests, and HPL, and the expected results from those tests. So with that, let's jump into the demo. So before we can deploy a CycleCloud server that's able to deploy clusters, we need to gather some values. The first value is the subscription ID. Once we have the subscription ID, we'll need to go find the service principal information needed. To do that, you'll click on App Registration here, and then click the service principal that you'd like to use. Here now you have an application ID, which you'll need, as well as the tenant ID. The final value that you will need is the client secret. The client secret can be generated by clicking on New Secret, and for here we're going to use GTC Demo. And then after that, you can choose an expiration date or time. So we're going to choose 3 months for this and click Add. And now we have this client secret value that we can use. And with that, we have all four values that we will need to configure our CycleCloud server. We are now ready to deploy a CycleCloud server. So first we have our resource group with our storage account and our virtual network, and we're ready to create our server. So we type in CycleCloud and we'll select Azure CycleCloud. We're going to use version 8.1, and we'll come down and we'll select our region, which will be East US 2, and we'll give our machine a name. We're now ready to set up our SSH keys so we can connect. So we're going to use one in our database, and we're going to select a public key that's stored in Azure Key Vault. We'll then look at disks. If you need more space, you can add a Dune disk. We will then look at networking to see we have the right network. And at this point, we are ready to review and create our machine. So this all looks good, so I'm going to click Create. And we'll now wait a little bit. To save everybody's time, we've sped this deployment process up for the demo. But it's going to create all these resources. It creates, and now it's deployed. And we are good to go see what we've deployed. So now that we've done that, we're going to click on the resource group, which is GTC Demo. And that'll take us to the resource group that we started with. And you can now see that we have GTC CC server. And now we're going to click on that virtual machine. And this will be the machine for our CycleCloud server. So now that we have our server, we'll copy our public IP address. And we'll go to our web browser. And we will plug in that IP address. And that will pull up the interface so that we can define our site, which in this case, we're going to use my cluster. And then once we have that, we're going to go and agree to the license agreement. And now we're going to plug in the information for the admin user. So I'm going to put in their Azure admin. I'll put my name in there for John. I'll add my password and confirm it. After that, it's optional, but I've chosen to plug in my public SSH key. And with that, I can click Done. At this point now, it's going to ask us for those four values that we showed you previously how to get. So first I'm going to plug in my tenant ID, followed by my application ID, followed by my application secret, and your subscription ID is already in. Once that's done, click on Validate Credentials, and it will, if it succeeds, it'll be able to connect to your subscription. You can now choose the location where you want your default location of clusters to be deployed, what resource group you want to use, as well as the storage account we'd like to use. And with that, your server is now configured to be able to deploy clusters in your environment. So from here, we're going to go back to clusters now, where you can see the default options to deploy various kinds of clusters. We now would like to add a custom environment to CycleCloud that enables us to use Pixis, Enroute, and Slurm. To do that, we have this GitHub repository called ccslurmngc, where I go through the instructions of how to configure CycleCloud to be able to run this environment. So first we're going to click on CycleCloud initialize, and we're going to go to our CycleCloud server, and we're going to run that command. So first we'll grab it, and we'll go there, we'll paste it, and then we're going to need our IP address for our CycleCloud server, and we can paste that there. We then need to use the same username which we used for configuration, which was Azure Admin, and that password, and that enables us to have CycleCloud set up and ready to go. Next, we need to pull down the CycleCloud project and make sure the server is ready. So we copy these lines down to the cd dot dot, and we can paste those onto the CycleCloud server, and we run those, and that will run through all the different things and make sure that we are ready to run those projects. And we're going to be downloading the project from CycleCloud, and that'll take a bit. And now that we have all that data, as you can see, it's pulling it down. So next we are going to go back, and we'll need to get our CycleCloud locker information, because that's the project or the area we need to upload our data. So now that we have that values, let's grab the last remaining command, which is to upload all this information that we've downloaded and customized and set up. And we'll plug in the my subscription dash storage value. And with that, what we've done is going to be uploaded to the storage account, which we defined previously. Now this has been sped up a bit to demonstrate what will be done. Once that's all uploaded, we are going to copy the last two lines. And as you can see here, it's the same default options. But as we go back, once everything's been uploaded, we hit that, we import our new CycleCloud Slurm NGC template. And when we go back and now we look at CycleCloud and we refresh, you can see that we have a new option in there called ccslurmngc. And this will be the cluster template that we will use for our cluster deployment. We are now ready to create our own cluster. So we're going to select the ccslurmngc template, and we're going to give it a name of CCA100. Next, we're going to choose the VM type that we'd like to deploy. For this demo, we're going to use the ND96 ASR V4. And we'll click Apply. And then we're going to select the number of HPC cores that we'd like to deploy. And this is the number of VMs times 96 that you would like. And in our case, we're going to deploy 2. We'll then select the subnet that we want to deploy these compute nodes in. We'll go Next. Here, we're going to select how much NFS disk space we like. It's set at 100 gigabytes, but you can set that higher for your needs. We're now going to go in and change the images that we're going to use for our deployment from the standard ones to the Ubuntu HPC 1804 latest marketplace image. And then we'll click Next. And here, if you'd like to do any further customization, you can add a cloud init script. So with that, we're ready to start our cluster. So click start. It'll ask if you want to, yes. And now it's going to go through the deployment process of first creating the scheduler, now acquiring the resources for it, finding the host IP address, then configuring the software for this cluster, and also creating some nodes that we'll deploy our compute nodes in. At this point, we're ready to deploy the compute VMs. So we're going to click on the HPC template. We're going to go down to the two machines, select them, and click on Start. Click OK. And at this point, you can see that CycleCloud is acquiring the compute VMs. And now it's configuring the software on both of them. And at this stage now, the compute nodes are ready, and you are ready to log into your cluster. Once you've logged into the cluster, you can do an sinfo, and you can see that we have two compute nodes up. We're then going to verify that Slurm is working as expected. We're going to do an srun, and we're going to run a NVIDIA SMI. And you can see that it reports the 8 GPUs, and things look good. So we're good to go to the next stage. We will now run a nickel single node test. Now this, you can find the instructions on how to run that from our CC Slurm NGC repository. We're going to do an sbatch nickel.sub, and we're going to look at the log files that Slurm provides. And as you can see, it's starting to run, and on a single node test, we expect about 235 gigabytes a second. For the nickel 2 node test, we can run the nickel dot sub and specify two nodes. We'll then look at the log files as well. And as you can see, it starts up, shows that it's running on 16 GPUs. And for the two node case, we expect between about 185 and 190. To run the single node HPL test, you can find the instructions on the CC Slurm NGC GitHub repository. To launch it, we're going to do an sbatch HPL.sub, and we're going to look at the logs. Now, this container that we're using is the generic HPL NGC container. It's not optimized for all the different GPUs, so it's going to give you good results, but it won't give you the optimal results like when which we published for the top 500. But you can see that in this case, it is reporting about 89 teraflops. For the two-node HPL test, we're going to submit it like we did prior, but we're going to use n equals 2 for two nodes. We're going to look at the logs again. And you can see that the instantaneous gigaflops are higher, but over time they ramp down as it continues to solve. And in this case, we report just shy of 160 teraflops.